hit that bloody like button for this. Hi, Dream Code is here back again, and guys, today we're going to advance our code. So in the previous video we were right here, and right now we want to display audio from this video. So I searched a little bit on the internet and I found out that we can't use actually Python 3 because I can't install the library, the audio library, which is, if we try to go into Python 3, we should import something like import ffpyplayer. That actually we can import this, but we can't import the actually we can import the cv2, sorry, import the cv2, we can import it. So because we can't install the audio library in Python 3, we are going to use Python today. So if I'm going to play to insert here Python, we're gonna see that we don't even have Python. So Python, nothing happened, and we're gonna install Python, guys. No Python. So right now I'm going to install Python, guys, and that's how you can install it. And we can see that something is not okay. I just reboot my machine, then I try to run again or sudo install python, then I had something like you must manually run sudo configure minus r to correct the problem. Then I installed back the Python. Now I can install it. So right now I'm installing the Python with sudo apt install python. So it seems that after all everything works after we reboot it, and we are going to continue. So right now we have Python. If I'm pressing here Python, you can see that I can type here. So if I want to press here to import actually cv2, we can't import cv2 because we actually installed cv2 only for Python 3. So I'm going here into my two lines of installation, apt-get install python minus pip. I'm going to install pip for Python right now because I want to install the cv2 library using the pip, not the pip3 as I did in the how to install opencv in Python 3. Don't worry, you're gonna have these lines on the description, so you can use them if you want. Now we have the pip installed and ready to go. The next step is to install the cv2. So pip install, and we're going to press here opencv-python. We are going to install the opencv for Python, not for Python 3. If you want to install for Python 3, you should type here pip3. So right now let's install the bloody cv2, guys. Also we have a new software update, and let's do this. I'm going to install software updates because it's really okay to do that. And we have numpy and opencv ready to go. Then I'm going to enter python, then import cv2. Right now we are on python, and also import numpy. Everything works as expected, guys, and we have two libraries ready to go. And right now for the final step, we have to install the ffpip. So pip install ffpip p actually and player ffpyplayer. We need to install this player because this player, we are using this player to show the audio from the video, and as we can see we can't do this. We must do something like pip install minus minus upgrade and cython. I know what's that, but we have to do this. So pip install minus minus upgrade cython, because we have here a problem on the compilation. Then after doing that, we should do pip install ffpyplayer, and it should, it haven't worked, so we're going to do something else of solve for this problem. I installed the ffpyplayer with this link, and actually it works. So if I'm going to enter on Python, then if I'm going to import, to try to import the ffpyplayer dot player, import, let's see, it seems that it worked. So you have to install the ffpyplayer with this, and also it should work for Python 3. It should work for Python 3 as well. Let's see. So pipe 3. Now it's downloading, and it's really simple. So we don't need to actually the pip to install this. I think it will work for Python 3 as well. Now it's running for either Python 3. You're gonna find everything into the description, guys, so don't worry. So yeah, successfully installed for Python 3. So when I'm typing here Python 3, then when I'm trying to import the ffpyplayer point player, then everything is just fine. Nice. So we're heading back to our code, guys, because we want to add the audio. So we want to record and show audio. You're gonna have everything in the description, so don't worry, you can use my commands, everything will work. So on the read video, I'm going to add another script, read video audio, that by, and I'm going to move this into Python basics. Then I'm going to copy everything inside this new script. So we are getting the video source, then we should compile this Python basics. So right now it should work. Python 3 read video and audio .py, and we have the video, but we don't have the sound. That was a problem. So pressing Q, so we should import first numpy as mp np, I said. Okay, import ffplayer dot player, actually from this, from that, import this media player. I'm gonna save this, then I'm going to compile to see if everything works. Everything works, it seems that we can use this. So we are getting the source right here. We should also get the media player from the source path. So I'm doing something like player equals with media player from the source path. Source path. Now we have everything here. Then after we read the frame, after we do this camera dev read, we also should read the audio. So audio frame, then we can use vol equal with the player dot get frame. So at each frame we read the audio frame. So if we let this like it is, we should hear something, I think. I'm not sure. Let's try to run this to compile this. It should. Yeah, you can see we have the audio. You see? So we have the audio, but it can be possible that the program to break or something at the end. Or maybe no. How cool is that, guys? We have video and we have audio as well. So nice. Hit that bloody like button for this. So cool. Nice video. And as you can see, we have a problem at the end of the video. As I told you, we have this problem at resize because it's like the last frame or something like that, and I'm trying to fix that right now. We should check the frame to see if the red, actually if not red, or if red is different than zero. That's what I understand by not red. Then we're gonna print something like end of video. Then we're going to break, because this is like the last frame. We're going to break because it's like the last frame. Then we should also check if the audio frame, this one, is not known. So we should break right here. We should just break. And let's see right now if I'm playing back this. Audio is getting. Let's only do something else like audio frame. And let's actually display let's only do this. You can see we are having the audio. Let's try to print the frame and T to see what are those frame then. Let's print the T. I'm really interested on knowing what are those two. Also, I want to print the audio. I'll clear this. And also red different than zero. End of video equals with zero. Okay, so as we can see, we have frame and we have see like some numbers. These are like some values which you can get from the audio. I think these are like audio values and these are like timestamps, stuff like that. But I'm really interested to find out if at the end of the video we'll have an error. So yeah. So cool, guys. We have video, guys. We have it. Nice. Also, I'm going to show you, as you can see, we have end video and we don't have any error. Also, I'm going to show you the script from where I'm inspiring. And if you guys like this, don't forget to hit that bloody like button because we displayed audio from video. Also, I'm going to say this here. I'm going to add this and I'm going to let the code into the description so you guys can get it pretty fast. Status, then git commit, edit read audio video audio from mp4 from videos actually, and I'm going to push everything git pull and git push everything. So yeah, and everything is ready, guys. Don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe. See ya next week. Don't forget to ring my bell and